because they're going to see Todd's back. So it's up to you. Yeah, that's fine. But maybe check with Harry to make sure. Yeah, I just want to make sure. Ready, Todd? Okay. Ready, Mara?
Yeah, I'm going to need you to move your chair a little forward.
Which way?
Forward. Much better, thank you.
Is that good? Can you still see Michelle?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. All right. One here. I'm going to introduce you. All right, everybody. We are going to get started here. First of all, just want to thank all of you for being here. This is going to be a fantastic event, a fantastic hour of music. Let's see. I wanted to let you know that if Todd has merchandise for sale in the back. There's albums, there's artwork, and there's t-shirts, and they're all totally awesome. So when the show is done, Todd is going to run back there, and he is going to be available for anything that you would like to purchase. For anyone on our live stream, we are going to be showing where you can donate via Venmo or PayPal. And there's also a program that's on Todd's website. So anyone who is watching via live stream, you can pull up that program. Anyone here, we would prefer you kept your phones off just because we want to make sure that that we have enough power for the Wi-Fi to so that the live stream doesn't get disrupted. And I really want to thank a big thank you to Mira Kehoe, Zion Lutheran Church, Mira over there. Thanks, Mira. And she is with Arts on Lafond, and they are a group that is co-sponsoring this event, and they have events going on throughout the year, so you should definitely check them out, Arts on Lafond. And then last but not least, and something that I'm very excited about, because as many as you know, I'm really bad at technology. Look what I did. Ever since Todd started doing these, I wanted to put the show on. I wanted to do the show so bad, and I wanted to have it on a big screen so everybody could see what we're playing, because these scores are amazing, and they're totally fun to play. So I got that up and running, and we're going to go through each score. as we're playing each one. So you guys are going to get to see that up on the screen. And without any further ado, everyone, Todd Harper.
We'll introduce everybody in a moment. But this is with everybody. Rev Sumac. It's that time of year. I walk near the burial mounds near Mounds Park, overlooking the Mississippi. See rows of sumac. It's out. You can use it for dye. Dyes your fingers. Dye for cloth. I'm gonna try making some paint out of it. And you can make a citrusy flavored tea with it. It's tangy. Very sharp. Goldfinches and all kinds of birds and chizzy-wizzies fly through the air. Warm afternoon. Cool.
Thank you.
wedding. Bird myth number 6. Matty Harris on bass clarinet. And this is a quartet with Matty, Gary Schulte, Aaron, and Michelle. Become whippoorwills or badgers or sandhill cranes or anything, northern pike. But then they scurry and hide, change back into shapes, and fade into colors and disappear. What was that? Thank you. sunset. A child on a boat in a big lake in summer bursts into tears as the sun starts to descend. Don't let it go away! Don't let it go! He shrieks. It gets darker. He falls asleep in his father's arms. And the older you get, the faster the sunset. Now, it's just a blink. Soon, the birch leaves will turn yellow against a deep blue sky, whirl in the wind's gust as they float to the earth. I'll see you there. Aaron Kerr. Life is interesting for a medium-sized predator. Big enough to be alpha around field mice, rats, maybe a sick muskrat, unwary cats, grasshoppers, rabbits. The one near Ian's house that was burying them in the compost heaps near his peach trees. And they collect things like Gary told me about one that went ziggity-zag, ziggity-zag, ziggity-zag in his yard, and two dogs were chasing it, and he totally confused them. And then his friend up in Madeline Island put his shoes outside his door, nice shoes, colorful, and came out the next morning and one of them was gone, only one. He walked and walked and walked through the forest and eventually came to a cache of treasures, cell phones, acorns, pine cones, pieces of clothing, and a shoe. But then, by then, it was all ratty and kind of box spit on it and you didn't want to wear it. They collect things like their friends from Blue Jays. Shiny things, colorful things. And they go ziggity-zag in the fields because they're not quite the alpha predator. Sometimes they have to hide behind chord changes. Or rocks, or trees, or something. But dear fox, beware of the golden eagles of Mongolia, trained by fierce Mongols who have golden eagles on their arms, chasing them. Beware of coyotes, grizzly bears, lynxes, bobcats, freeways. All those things. But be most of all careful of descendants of the British aristocracy.
Thank you.
take out the stickle hovels and all those things. But Eric Satie is out of his element. Take away the sea.
It's gonna be a humdinger of a season.
Schulte, Kinney, and Gary Schulte, who rounded out and propelled that group forward. You can find that CD someplace. It's around. It'll lift your spirits. So this composition is dedicated to Kerr Thomas, who played with Paul and I for years and years. January New Moon. It's dark. Dark moon, where everything comes out of. All the dreams, creative things. This January, something's off.
Thank you.
cover for. Ambito. This is from a list of 23 emotions, or 32 emotions, that are not commonly known. Sensory details found it on the internet. A safe thing. Sunlight through winter tinted windows explodes bubbles in a water glass. Thank you. drops, ripples into the earth's veins. On its path to the deep earth. Where water bubbles up.
Thank you.
5:30, great violinist, our local friend David Stumpsell left Planet. Played with Boiled and Lead and a lot of Arabic music and things with incredible time signatures. And he laughed and played them anyway. Played lots of things, but he left. And this is dedicated to him. It features Laura Harada. Time common. It is more than 4:04. sudden risks, or death. Tell them not to leave. Sparrow. flies to a place where there aren't any trees, way up in the tundra, to lay its eggs. And why is it called the tree sparrow and not the tundra sparrow? But I see this sparrow, and it looks kind of like chipping, but I'm not sure. It kind of looks a little bit like a warbler, but what's the difference between warblers and sparrows anyway? Hell, when I was a teenager, all I wanted to do was experience sparrowness. What an arrogance. Oh, I can just kind of think, yeah, like I can flop around and even take to the air. They know their names for themselves, but what kind of sparrow is that? Or is it a phoebe? Or a gnatcatcher? Or a hermit thrush? Well, I learned a few things from my dad. The robin's rain song, white-throated sparrows, an oven bird. But now my dad's gone, and I can't ask him. Oh, if I would have asked. So I look at these identification guides and get lost. Geometry for small shorebirds. I'm visiting Bob and Ann in the Bay Area, and we walk along the wild beach at Pescadero State Park. It's not really sunny, but it's not really stormy. But the waves are still crashing in. Drama in real life. And a timely, ghostly, transparent little bird is darting in and out of waves rolling to the shore, snatching yum-yums and coming out again, and then flying off. Angles everywhere, right, obtuse, cute. And then they make another one, and another one. Saturdays? Semi-palmated sandpiper? Wilson's phalarope? A truncated scrub heron? Wilmer dowager? Who knows? Folks don't really identify this transparent little bird, which I know wasn't a ghost, because Anne saw it too. This little bird has no time for equations, or proofs, or theorems, or spreadsheets. A bite of a gull friend could end its life in a second. It's all geometry. It's all planes. Line segments, angles, and flight. A whole life as a continuous line segment. Oh, teach me geometry, oh mysterious little shorebird. I know nothing. back in March 28th, 2020. It didn't happen. So I had to keep writing. We met, rehearsed once, and said, oh, this is great. So then I wrote a whole bunch of stuff, and Lauren said, Todd, quit writing so many things. Aaron said, Todd, stop writing so many things. So we did about a quarter of it. I want to thank, first of all, second of all, third of all, my newest friend, Matty Harris. Oh yes, and I want to thank one of my other new friends that I've known a long time and finally got a chance to play with. You can see her playing in lots of places. Michelle Kinney on cello. Thank you.
Oh, okay.
I did.
I think I see the Brazilian, so I should check out the shoot me an email or give me a call.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be really cool.
Great to see you.
Thanks, Mike.